involved in it. The whole hospital and all the staff knew about it and were involved in it. The very fact that such a study was being conducted enthused a lot of people to do their jobs well, and perhaps more well. And the patients also felt that they had some role to play in the way they were taken care of, though exceptions were certainly there. And some key messages to the top management also could be conveyed. For me, doing the study was very important, much more important than the result of the study. It was a positive learning experience, and so I plan to repeat it after short intervals so that it doesn't become a routine boring affair with newer questions, so that the staff are alert and I also do not get complacent. In conclusion, I would not call this a study that I did. This was an activity that I did, and I did not do it for the LDP. I did it because of the LDP. This is my team of leaders. I thank you all. Thanks to LDP.
Dr. Kiran, please collect a certificate from Dr. Partha. Dr. Loganathan is going to present next, and Dr. Mallikarjun will be on the next podium.
Sir, respect our dignitaries on the dais and off the dais. My dear friends, very good morning to one and all. So my study is a prospective comparative study between subtenous block and periverbal block in patients undergoing small incision cataract surgery. So cataract surgery, as you know, it's commonly done under local anesthesia, though periverbal block is most popular technique among the surgeons. And though the needle block is rarely produce serious complications like globe injuries, so subtenous block is less invasive compared to the needle blocks. So choice of anesthesia for particularly the cataract surgery depends upon the patient selection as well as the surgeon comforts and surroundings. So the aim of this study is to compare the akinetic effect and as well as the analgesic effect of the periverbal block and subtenous blocks in patients undergoing small incision cataract surgery. So materials and methods, 100 patients randomly selected, 50 in each group, present to the Department of Ophthalmology, who were diagnosed with cataract. So patients in the age group between 40 to 80 were included. Patients known to allergic to lignocaine as well as mentally challenged were excluded from the study. So preoperatively routine evaluation were done, and lignocaine test was given to all patients. Periverbal anesthesia as well as subtenous given with the 2% xylocaine with 1 in 2 lakh certain dilution with sodium hyaluronidase. So 3 minutes, sorry for, we'll play the video later. So 3 minutes prior to subtenous anesthesia, topical anesthetic propocarine was instilled and followed by injection of 2 ml of anesthetic drug in the infranasal quadrant, 6 mm away from the limbus, injected into the subtenous space, and periverbal given in the 3 divided into 3 ml in each quadrant, supranasal as well as infratemporal quadrant. And after this, all patients underwent SICS. So data were entered in Microsoft Excel sheet, and mean and proportions were used to analyze the results. So 100 patients underwent SICS from between November 2017 to January 2018, and 50 patients were in each group. So 46 were males and 54 were females. Average age in the two groups, 65 and 67 years respectively. So dosage of anesthesia for average in periverbal is 6 ml and subtenon is only 2 ml. So rate of subconjunctival hemorrhage at the injection site is where 12 patients were subconjunctival hemorrhage in periverbal group, and only 2 patients had SCH at the injection site. And ocular echinosis adequate in almost 96% in periverbal, that is nil extraocular movements. So 2 patients need moderate movements which requires additional block. Whereas in subtenous block, all patients get minimal extraocular movements which will not affect the your surgery. And grade of pain using the visual analog pain scale, moderate in all cases during injection of the subtenous as well as periverbal. In subtenous groups, there is no pain experienced by 43 patients during the injection. And repeat block which required in periverbal block with 4 cases, whereas none of the patient requires repeat block in subtenon group. So So duration of anesthetic effect is adequate for completing the surgery in both the group. So post-op ocular pain pursued by the patients underwent peribulbar block. So patient, none of them complained subtenon group, no post-operative pain at the injection site. So intraoperative complication, one patient had iris pull-ups which was managed during surgery and in peribulbar, and no patients developed any complication both post-operatively in both the group. So patient comfort level, patients undergone peribulbar block as less comfortable compared to the subtenon group. So discuss both the techniques provide a good analgesic effect intraoperatively, and acritic effect was better with the peribulbar compared to subtenon block, and better post-operative comfort to the patient was better in the subtenon group. So the rate of subconjunctival hemorrhage and chemosis were more common in the peribulbar rather than subtenon group. The pain experienced by the patient during the block was found in most of the patients with peribulbar compared to subtenon group. So in a study by Tasnim Parker et al. Also concluded subtenon anesthesia is safe and effective, give good analgesia during and after surgery and comfortable to the patients. A similar study by Stern Zoroman, subtenon was found to be simple and non-traumatic technique and is good alternative to the peribulbar block. These are all my references. So to conclude, subtenon block is a better technique for anesthesia since it provides better ocular analgesia and adequate echinacea to complete surgery and adequate anesthesia, and most of all the lesser volume of the anesthetic drug, and patient comfort also better in subtenon group. So I would look to thank the AIOC ARC for developing the 2017 and 18 batch where they taught how to fit, so yesterday also they brought the Kangli, and how to be a team member among yourselves, how to relax in between your professional life, and also they taught us by giving scientific also by giving each products. Once again, I thank Partha sir and Nadarajan sir and the ARC team, AIOC, for giving the very good opportunity. I would request them to continue the same in a higher level. Thank you very much.